Time is always pushing forward. We're reminded of this fact every instant of our lives. But what is it that brings us from one moment in time to the next? The other day I was sitting at my desk trying to get some work done when I ended up zoning out, staring at the wall in front of me, and before I knew it, half an hour had gone by, but it didn't really feel that way. In those 30 minutes, time was moving very slowly, and in fact, it almost felt like it was standing still in that moment. And that experience got me considering the way that we think about time, more specifically, the way in which time passes. We take for granted that time is always moving forward, but how do we actually know that that's the case? Time is such a natural part of our lives that it seems odd to question whether it's really there. We tend to think of it as an objective part of our reality, and yet the very nature of time is so mysterious. It's almost poetic in a way. You've probably noticed that writers tend to describe time very metaphorically. They'll often compare it to water. Marcus Aurelius wrote that time is a sort of river of passing events, and strong is its current. No sooner is a thing brought to sight than it is swept by. I've never liked any of these comparisons because I've always felt like they were very ambiguous. If time is like a river, then are we flowing along with it, or are we watching it as an observer off in the distance? Do we move with time, or is time moving through us? Time exists in a twofold nature. There's the physical aspect, which we use as a unit of measurement, and then there's the psychological aspect, which gives us the feeling that time is passing. Time as we know it is always moving forward. The future flows into the present until it becomes part of the past. So essentially, time is going from what is to what will be. But if time is always moving, then how can the present exist? Wouldn't we encounter a paradox? You might consider this instant to be the present, but how long is this instant? Once you fully conceptualize this moment, it becomes part of the past. So in order for the present to exist, time must stand still. But if time is the product of movement and all movement stopped, then the concept of time would cease to exist and past, present, and future would be happening all at once. In physics, this concept is known as the block universe, which describes that time exists moment to moment, sort of like snapshots. MIT professor Max Tegmark said,
"We can portray our reality as either a three-dimensional place where stuff happens over time, or as a four-dimensional place where nothing happens. And if it really is the second picture, then change really is an illusion, because there is nothing that is changing. It's all just there, past, present, future."
It could very well be true that reality is a timeless vortex of isolated possibilities, but this theory doesn't actually account for why it feels like time is passing, even if it isn't. It only makes sense to speak about time in the way that we've experienced it. So to say that the past and future exist as isolated possibilities is a rather inaccurate depiction of the human experience. We've all witnessed cause and effect, and naturally we've come to conclusions based off of that. The only thing we can reliably say is that it certainly feels like time is passing. So perhaps we ought to consider what causes this feeling and what might stop it. Even if the linear movement of time is an illusion, what creates this illusion? The concept of time is very important to us because it serves as the universal background of our lives. But if you were to analyze this background, you'd see that time is essentially the accumulation of memory and experience. If we imagine our lives as a book, this book is composed of many pages, and as you turn the page, it feels as though time is moving. But it's not time that's moving, it's us. We're the ones who flip the page. It's only when we look back at all the pages we've turned that we construct this illusion of past and future. If you can imagine the book in its totality, then there is no need for time at all. We believe that time is an apparent function of reality, but what we conceive to be time is just the gap between where we are and where we aren't. If you're focused on where you are, then the gap no longer exists. But the moment you think about where you aren't, you separate yourself from the present, and accordingly you must act under the constraint of time. Jiddu Krishnamurti describes time as the interval between idea and action. He asked,
"Can we live so completely that there is no tomorrow for thought to think about? So long as there is this interval of time which has been bred by thought, there must be sorrow, there must be continuity of fear. So one asks oneself, can this interval come to an end? As long as time exists as a means to something, the mind cannot go beyond itself."
Time provides us with a sense of security because it gives us continuity. Without time to rely on, how would you know who you are, where you've been, or where you're going? We've become so attached to these ideas that in our minds we construct the illusion of time, but our memories ultimately limit our reality so that we can never experience anything beyond the confines of our own conditioning. True freedom can only exist in the absence of memory, and memory is the product of thought. So where there is thought, there must be time. But if we are the ones who create time, then surely we can transcend it. So that about summarizes my views on time. I'd be interested to hear yours. Do you think that time passes? And if it's like a river, are we flowing along with it, or are we watching it as an observer? Let me know in the comments, and I will see you all in my next video. Take care, everyone.